Willie has been honored by his peers in the field of gospel music by being inducted into the Southern Gospel Music Hall of Fame. This didn't happen by accident. It took years of hard work and many sacrifices, and most of all, his tremendous love and dedication to gospel music. Let's take a moment to look at Willie's background and history that led up to this award. In fact, let's go way back to see the foundation that Willie built upon as he pursued his love of gospel music. Willie was born Wilbur Oliver Wynn on the family farm in South Georgia on December 13, 1937. This humble beginning instilled in him the values and rewards of hard work. Picking cotton by hand was something he was good at, much better than one of his brothers, or so I'm told. Working on the farm was hard, with long, hot days and very low income. Picking cotton and working in the tobacco fields taught Willie one other thing, too, that there had to be a better way to make a living than farming. However, life on the farm was not all work and no play. Willie loved outdoor activities such as hunting and fishing. As you can see, he was good at fishing. Of course, there were school days, too. One of the pleasures of going to school was that he was allowed to wear his shoes. Growing up on the farm actually provided Willie the basic skills that would serve him well as a tenor singer. For example, calling hogs helped him to develop the ability to reach those high notes that he is so famous for. Willie honed those singing skills by singing in the choir at Hopewell Baptist Church. At this little country church, Willie came to love singing hymns and gospel music. His singing skills continued to develop, and as a teenager, he was asked to sing with a local gospel group in Moultrie, Georgia, called the Happy Four Quartet. As a result of this experience, Willie became even more convinced that his goal in life was to sing gospel music. In 1958, at the age of 20, Willie was asked by Smitty Gatlin to audition with the Oak Ridge Quartet. Getting this audition was a big deal, and Smitty hired him. When Willie started singing with the Oaks, it consisted of Smitty Gatlin, Ronnie Page, Herman Harper, and Tommy Fairchild on the piano. Now, there were several changes to the Oak Ridge Quartet during the 15 years that Willie was the tenor with them. They changed the name to the Oak Ridge Boys, and there were changes to the singers and the instrumentalists. In 1962, Ronnie Page left the Oaks and was replaced by Gary McSpadden as the baritone. In 1963, Gary left the group and was replaced by Jim Hamill. And this is the sound of Willie and the Oak Ridge Boys in 1963. When Jim Hamill left the group in 1964, he was replaced by William Lee Golden, singing the baritone. Then in 1966, Smitty Gatlin left the Oak Ridge Boys and Duane Allen took over as the lead singer. It was also in 1966 when Willie and the Oaks appeared in the Marathon Pictures movie called Sing a Song for Heaven's Sake.
Oh.
In addition to concerts, Willie and the Yokes also appeared on various TV shows. One of these was the Porter Wagoner TV show. Then in 1969, Herman Harper, the bass singer, left the Yokes and was replaced by Noel Fox. During this time, the Yokes had gained even broader audience recognition and were on several TV shows, such as this one.
Let's welcome the Oak Ridge Boys.
The Johnny Cash Show was a big success on TV, and Willie and the Yokes had the opportunity to perform there, singing one of their most popular songs. It was also during this time that Willie and the Oak Ridge Boys received several Dove Awards and a Grammy. They were in more demand for television appearances now, such as this one with Jim Ed Brown on the Outlaw Music Channel. Many of the songs in these performances featured Willie's smooth tenor voice, as we see here in Homeward Bound. And another favorite featuring Willie is "The Grass Is Greener on the Other Side."
There'll be no more wars to pull a home apart. Heaven claims no tears or broken hearts. The grass is greener on the other side.
In the early 1970s, Willie and the Oak Ridge Boys were rated one of the top gospel groups in the business. It was songs such as "Mama's Last Amen" that pleased audiences all across the country.
Oh, Jesus, I don't
After Calvary was always an inspiration to all audiences when Willie sang it.
And I would be anything that you would have me be, 'cause after all,
In 1972, Richard Sturban's rich bass voice joined the Oak Ridge Boys. Listen to Willie now as he sings Stay Near to Me before a live audience. After 15 years singing with the Oak Ridge Boys, Willie left the group in 1973.